Hey guys, welcome if you're new, welcome back if you're returning. And today I thought I would show you an update of how things are going with my 2018 personal planner, since I haven't given an update since January before I started using this one. And before I get started, just a reminder, go on and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my other videos. I know you love planners and organizing, you'll love this channel. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started and just do like a quick flip through of how I've been using this planner. So the last time you saw this planner, it was completely blank, but what I was telling you was that I chose to make it kind of as plain as possible by just doing a gray interior design, and I'm going to be doing different color schemes or designs every week with stickers and washi and pens and stuff, because one of the problems I had with using the Happy Planner previously was it was like pre-decorated and I wanted to do my own decorating. So by leaving it kind of blank, it's sort of like a blank coloring book and I can design it how I want every week. So this was my first week, January 1st here, and you can see I did kind of like a pinks and purples theme. I used this washi with these feathers on it, which I really like, and then this other like diagonal stripe washi. And you'll see that I'm trying to do different things each week with my to-do lists. So here I did a little to-do sticker and added some items underneath that. Then on the second half of the week, I did like an arrow sticker and added my items here. And if you aren't familiar with my like note-taking philosophy, I've been using this planner exclusively for work. So I do have like a day job, office job. And so I just write all my appointments for the day, always in black ink. And then I do like a color that coordinates with my theme for the week to either check off the appointment when it's done, or I add a little X if it was canceled or moved, and then I'll make some little notes. So I don't always take notes. I'm not really good at like note-taking in meetings, but I do try to make a note if there's something that I'm going to want to remember that we discussed, and it has been helpful to be able to go back and refer to. So here's week two. It's kind of a snowflake design. Of course, there was much less snow this week in January than there is now at the end of March. And you can see I'm still doing my little like to-do list on each side of the week here. Now we're into week three. So this was like a red and black theme based on this washi tape that has this dream big highlighted here. There are some other phrases on this tape in other colors, but since the red one was highlighted, I went with a red and black. This little to-do sticker actually came with the personal planner sticker pack. And I also kind of thought it was funny that this says be bra. but you can see here, I've started putting my to-dos in this blank space at the bottom of the pages. Here's week four. This is one of my favorites. I think it's kind of simple and monochromatic, which I like. So I have some purple kind of tie-dye swirly sort of tape at the top and bottom of the week, and then this tape has some gold foil. So I have been trying to mark my days that I work from home, although you'll see I stopped that practice because it became too unpredictable. And then I also added a couple of flower stickers here from the Happy Planner, one of their sticker packs. And I am still doing the to-do list kind of in this blank space at the bottom of the page. So now we're into February. Guess who got a new pack of washi tape this week? So I kind of used everything all at once, and probably I should have just stuck with this floral, which is red. It's a black background with red, pink, and gray flowers, and then like these stripes of red. That would have been fine. But then I also wanted to add in this floral, which I thought was on a black background, but really it's dark blue, and that kind of bothers me that I now have blue and black together. But otherwise, you can see I actually pulled that blue out to use as my like pen highlight color for the week, and my to-do list was in red. And since I am only using this for work and only on weekdays, I tried adding the to-do list here on the Saturday spot. This week was kind of pretty. I used this like paisley washi tape to totally cover that top banner bar, so you can't even see the month or which week it is. And then these little skinny ones just to kind of separate out these areas. I never really know 100% what I'm going to use all the spaces for, so I might have put something else here if I needed to like make note or make a different to-do list, but I just had a to-do running here in the bottom area of the page. And again, my highlight color was the pink that I pulled out of this paisley design. Here we are on week 7 of the month, halfway through February. This was another of my favorites. It's pretty simple, so it's just these multicolored washies across the top and then a couple of bright yellow flowers down at the bottom from that Happy Planner sticker book again. It's hard to add other decorative stickers because I don't really know where I'm going to end up with space. Like, I might have ended up having 8,000 meetings this day, and if I had filled it all with flowers, I would have run out of room. So I don't really know until after the day is over how it's gonna fill up. This week I was a little disappointed with this is, you know, two of my favorite colors across the top here, but then this washi, I'm not sure if you can see, it's like a black background with a dark teal, very delicate design on it, and so I thought the teal would kind of match up with this color, and it does, but it looks kind of weird. It looks like a big black sensor bar or something across the page, and then again, I pulled out that kind of green color for my little accent for this week, and I'll also note there is this little, like, notes square here in the bottom corner, and since we had an activity going on for these couple weeks, I added that note in the bottom corners here for those weeks that it was happening. This is another of my favorites so far for the year. So I picked this big, large multicolored triangle with the gold foil design washi to go across the bottom of the week. And then across the top is a sort of a smaller triangle design, also in bright multicolors. And my to-do list is set off with this little star sticker. And I also have this one that says, "Be happy today," just to kind of jazz up this weekend space. And I use the hot pink is my little accent, pulling out some of these bright colors from here, and I really like how this week turned out. This was another one that I liked, so this was week 10 of the year, and again, I did like one big bold piece of washi across the bottom, and then kind of skinnier coordinating ones to balance it out, and I just added one big flower here, and again, this week I used the purple pen and ran my to-do list across the bottom of the page here. This is a real ugly week, but I was on vacation most of the time. So you see, I actually only had one day with stuff and then vacation. So this is actually a little sticker. This is obviously a sticker that's meant to go in the Happy Planner. It will fit those squares exactly, but since I'm not using that planner anymore, I'm not really using these size stickers, so I figured I'd just slam it on here where I didn't have anything else going on, and also one of these large quotes. So I thought, since I was traveling this week, this one was like sort of travel related. Go the extra mile, it's never crowded. Then this Saturday, again, I don't really use the planner for the weekends because it's kind of for work, but this was St. Patrick's Day, and I had these little St. Patrick's Day stickers, so I stuck one of those on there, and this is like a green and gold foil washi, and actually I'm gonna lift this up for one sec and try to show you. You can see that I picked up and removed the washi tape, and you can sort of see that it tore the paper a little when I moved it. So that's actually one drawback of the personal planner compared to the Happy Planner, is that the paper quality really just isn't quite the same. The Happy Planner, I have been easily able to lift and replace washi tape, and on this paper, it really just kind of tears. So here's the week that we're on currently. You can see I have my little bookmarker in here, and I do like how this color scheme came out. So this is like a dark purple across the top with like a blue design in it. It's very subtle, and so I use that purple and blue tape across the bottom as well, and then I'm using both blue and purple as kind of highlight colors for my to-do list. And again, it's pretty simple, but it looks nicely coordinated. And just to bring us through the end of March, I have finished decorating for next week, since I don't know when I'm going to have time to do that. So I've gone with this blue tape with these gold foil arrows, and then a kind of a coordinating teal across the bottom here. And the only thing that I had on this page so far was this little sticky note. So I kind of used that as my inspiration. So this has gold foil and blue, so that's why I ended up picking this washi tape. And then echoing kind of this banner shape here, I use this little banner shape sticker to mark my to-do area. And then just because I knew I would have some other blank space, I used this blue Be Happy Today sticker here in this kind of blank area. So hopefully you found that interesting. If you did, don't forget to give me a thumbs up or leave me a comment and let me know what you thought. If there's anything else you want to see with regards to my personal planner, let me know. And thanks for watching. Again, I will see you next time.